I give up.
Hey, what's wrong, sport?
Hey, Stampy. It's this engineering class. I can't figure out how something like the Spitzer Space Telescope stays so cold in space.
Sounds like you've got a question for NASA. You should write to them.
I can email NASA?
Even better, you can mail them a real letter. Taking that extra time shows NASA you really care.
Sounds like a first-class idea, Stampy. Get it? First class.
Yeah, I never heard that one before. Whoa! Let's get this letter to NASA. That'll do the trick. Special delivery!
Hey, Stampy, got another letter for me?
You know it.
How does Spitzer stay cool? Great question. You see, Stampy, Spitzer is an infrared telescope. Infrared light comes from anything that's warm, even from things that are really, really cold and only a tiny bit warm.
Wow!
To detect infrared light from really cold space objects, Spitzer's instruments need to be even colder than those objects. Ideally, just a few degrees above absolute zero.
Zero is a number!
I think this hologram and handwritten note should explain it pretty well.
I don't think you can reuse stamps. Okay, let's do this! Special delivery!
Whoa, talk about airmail!
Yeah!
So, Spitzer was launched into space with liquid helium coolant to keep its instruments cold. But to help them stay cold longer, Spitzer was sent into an Earth-trailing orbit. This means it orbits the sun behind the Earth, far from the Earth's warmth.
I bet that's a crazy temperature difference, huh, Stampy?
I'm just a stamp.
In addition, the telescope's solar panels were mounted on a large structure to basically provide shade from the sun's light and heat. These passive cooling techniques meant Spitzer could make a small amount of liquid helium coolant go a lot farther. And launching with less coolant saved NASA over $1 billion. Ah, this is really helpful.
That's engineering for you. Well, thanks for watching.
But I have another question.
Uh-oh.
How come Spitzer is all black and silver?
Is that a clever engineering thing too?
Or is that just a funky design choice?
New stamps are surprisingly inexpensive. I can't feel my brain. Special me bubble me!
Spitzer is black and silver because it's both clever and funky.
Yeah!
You see, silver reflects light, while black absorbs and re-radiates light more than any other color. Together, black and silver help redirect the flow of heat around the telescope.
You're saying science!
I have another hologram that depicts this exact point.
That seems implausible. Oh boy. Island choo-choo train!
Chicka-chicka-choo-choo!
So, solar panels capture the sun's energy to power the telescope.
Scumpy-dumpy-doo!
But the rest of that side is silver to reflect the extra light away. Now some light is absorbed and converted to heat, so there's a black strip here to help radiate it back into space.
Ooh.
Heat that gets through would be re-emitted as light over here, hitting the silver side of the telescope's barrel and bouncing off. And whatever light does get absorbed is pretty much immediately conducted to the black side of the barrel and radiated safely away. The end result is, those black and silver colors keep the telescope's sensitive instruments even colder. Wow, sounds like those engineers really thought about this.
I'm Stampy.
And you really addressed my question. Thanks, NASA engineering person.
You're welcome, letter writer.
See you next time.
Time.
I should send a thank you letter.
Yeah!